If you live in the US, chances are your home uses forced air central ducted heating. In Europe, radiant heating is actually most common. We'll explore the advantages, drawbacks, and frequently asked questions of radiant versus forced air. I'm Kata. Welcome to Net Zero Tech. If you live in the US and you think about radiant heating, you probably think about in-floor heating. In Europe, radiant heaters at walls are the most common heat distribution system. In the 50s and 60s, radiant floor heating was actually very popular in the US. As the cost of electricity grew, the cost became prohibitive. Regulating a home's temperature is always an interplay between heating system and insulation. That's why I always try to encourage to improve insulation, especially if there are quick winds like drafts. According to the US Department of Energy, space heating is the largest home energy expense, accounting for 45% of monthly energy bills. The way you heat your home will have a major impact on how much you pay to stay warm. I like to emphasize that radiant and forced air are methods of heat distribution. The heating system includes both the source of the heat and the heat distribution. Radiant heat distribution systems work by directly warming objects and people in a space. This is achieved through the emissions of infrared radiation from a heated surface, such as a radiant panel, floor, or ceiling. Unlike forced air systems, which circulate heated air through a room, radiant heat delivers warmth where it is needed most, near occupants and surfaces. The four advantages of radiant heating that I see are comfort, energy efficiency, air quality, and silent operation. Radiant heat provides a more consistent and comfortable temperature throughout a room, with fewer temperature fluctuations than forced air systems. Because radiant heat doesn't rely on ductwork or air circulation, it can be more energy efficient, resulting in lower utility bills over time. Without the need for air ducts, radiant heat reduces the circulation of dust, allergens, and other particles in the air, leading to improved indoor air quality. Radiant heating systems operate silently without the noise associated with forced air systems, making them ideal for bedrooms and other quiet spaces. So what are the disadvantages? Radiant heating systems typically have higher upfront installation costs compared to forced air systems, especially if you're retrofitting an existing home. Radiant heat systems can take longer to reach the desired temperature compared to forced air systems, which can heat a room more quickly. While radiant heat provides efficient heating, it may not be ideal for cooling, depending on your insulation and your climate. A forced air heat distribution system simply refers to units that use air blowers to distribute warm or cold air throughout a building via ductwork and vents. Forced air heating is a common choice in many homes in the US due to the widespread availability and relatively low cost. But what are the pros and cons of forced air compared to radiant heating? A lot of the disadvantages of radiant heating are actually advantages of forced air heating. Forced air systems can heat a room rapidly, making them ideal for quickly warming up spaces when needed. The heated air is blown through the ducts and distributed rapidly, resulting in a rapid increase in temperature throughout the room. This makes forced air heating ideal in situations where immediate warmth is desired. In addition to heating, forced air systems can easily be equipped with central air conditioning, humidification, and air filtration components. Many forced air heating systems include built-in air conditioning, providing both heating and cooling functions in one system, providing year-round comfort. This integrated cooling capability offers convenience and flexibility, allowing homeowners to maintain a comfortable temperature throughout the year without the need for a separate cooling system. One of the advantages of forced air heating systems is their lower upfront installation costs compared to radiant floor heating systems. Forced air systems utilize ductwork that's commonly installed in homes. This makes the installation process more straightforward and typically more cost-effective. One of the drawbacks of forced air heating systems is the potential for uneven heat distribution throughout a room. The forced air can create drafts and temperature variations within the room, leading to uneven heating. Certain areas may feel warmer than others, while some spots may experience cooler temperature. This inconsistency in heat distribution can result in discomfort for occupants and may require adjustments to achieve the desired comfort levels. The circulation of air in forced air heating systems can contribute to the distribution of dust, allergens, and pollutants throughout the home. As the system pushes air through the ducts, any contaminants present in the ductwork can be carried along and dispersed into the living spaces. This can potentially affect indoor air quality, particularly for individuals with respiratory conditions or allergies. Forced air systems can produce noise during operation, particularly when the air is forcefully pushed through the ducts and vents, as well as the operation of the furnace. The sound of air moving through the ducts and the operation of the blower fan and the opening and closing of registers can contribute to the overall noise level in the home. This noise can be disruptive and may affect the tranquility of the living space, especially in quiet environments or during nighttime. Forced air systems typically have energy loss through duct leaks and uninsulated ducts, reducing overall efficiency and increasing heating costs. Leaky ducts can allow heated air to escape into unconditioned spaces, such as attics and crawl spaces or walls, resulting in energy waste. This energy loss can reduce the overall energy efficiency of the heating system, leading to higher energy bills and a less environmentally friendly solution. Regular maintenance and inspections are essential to identify and repair a duct leak and to optimize energy efficiency. These pros and cons should give you a good basis to make a decision. Now, there are a few questions left that haven't already been covered. For instance, can in-floor heating be installed in existing homes? Yes, any kind of radiant heating can be installed in existing homes. However, it may require lifting and replacing the flooring, which can be time-consuming and costly. It is best to consult with a professional to assess the feasibility and cost of retrofitting. Can radiant floor heating be used for cooling as well? Radiant floor heating systems are primarily designed for heating purposes. They can be used for cooling as well. If you don't use a separate cooling system, such as air conditioning, and you live in a humid area, make sure you have sufficient insulation and/or air circulation to avoid condensation on the windows or moisture building up. Separate cooling systems, such as air conditioning, may be required for some of the units. So, which heating system is most cost-effective in the long run? The long-term cost-effectiveness of any heating system depends on a variety of factors, including energy efficiency, operational costs, and maintenance requirements. The radiant floor heating's energy efficiency typically leads to lower energy bills over time, making it more cost-effective in the long run. So, which heating system is right for you? Ultimately, the decision depends on your specific needs, budget, and preferences. If you prioritize comfort, energy efficiency, and silent operation, radiant heat may be the best option for you. Radiant heat is particularly well suited for homes with high ceilings, large windows, or rooms with hard surfaces like tiles or concrete. If upfront cost, quick heating, and versatility are your top priorities, forced air heating may be the way to go. Forced air systems are often preferred in homes with existing ductwork or in regions where certain air conditioning is a necessity. In the radiant heat versus forced air debate, there is no one-size-fits-all answer. Both systems have their own set of advantages and disadvantages. So it's essential to weigh your options carefully before making a decision. Whether you choose radiant heat for its comfort and energy efficiency or opt for forced air for its affordability and versatility, the goal is the same: to keep you warm and cozy year-round. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great time and see you next week. Cost effectiveness.
The long term.
Cost effectiveness.